placing building objects on a plain blue Unity default background. Makes sense. But if I had a game environment like this? Oh yeah, let's build a nice house at the water. At the water. Nah, better in the water. Saves shower time. Well, I understand if you don't like your houses being built into water. Let's see how we can prevent the player from placing anything into a certain area, and also how we can prevent building objects from overriding each other. I added the tileset package from my Tilemap basics tutorial, created a new palette, and added the new set as tiles. Now I am going to add a tilemap for the environment, where placing will be allowed, so that is basically the ground. It doesn't really matter. But what about this empty part? I create a second tilemap for forbidden placement. And if you need to, you can also have several maps which should be forbidden. The code will handle it. But more to this later. So I want the grass to be buildable and the water not. Makes sense. If you followed the previous tutorial for the eraser, you can see now that you can erase your environment. Might be an interesting game idea, but let's fix this. In your tool controller, you would have to expand the filter criteria, but since all our generated tilemaps start with tilemap underscore, we can invert the filter and only keep those whose names start with tilemap underscore. Now that we can't delete our background, let's code the actual placement logic. Go to your building creator script. First of all, let's add a new serialized field, a list of tilemaps. All maps in those lists will be evaluated for the placement logic. So this means if any of those maps has a tile at a given position, the placement will not be allowed. Now we can add a new method with a boolean as return value. The method will check if the placement at the given position is forbidden. We're going to use the any method from the system.link package. For every map, we will check if it has a tile at a position. If it has, the method will stop looping through the remaining maps and returns true for our isForbidden method. If there is no tile, it will check the next map. If no map has a tile, it will simply return false and therefore placement will be allowed. Now we just need to implement this method at the needed positions. For one, I want no preview to be shown where I can't place anything. Right above is the preview logic for a single placement. The first line is fine because it removes the preview from the previous position. So let's just wrap the second line in an if statement. If the placement is not forbidden for the position as parameter, then we will preview the tile. Due to the changes in the last episode, all the remaining logic for either preview of rectangle and lines, as well as the real placement, happen in the drawItem method. Note that I will not restrict the tools, as it might be possible that they can alter terrain or happen on forbidden areas, like a planning tool. So, I just make sure that the setTile call only happens if the given position is not forbidden. That's mainly the logic. Let's give it a try. You can see that there is no preview above the water, and I also can't place anything. So you see nothing. That's good. But it is also just logical that I can't place a table on top of a wall, or can I? Remember that even though we show it as item, the door is handled and placed as wall, so that it fits nicely in the walls. So we need some real items now. I provided the best of my arts and created this cute little table and this comfy chair. They are configured as item and will be placed on the item map now. Yeah, okay, my UI is really shitty. But at least they can be placed. And who doesn't like to eat on top of a wall? So let's implement a way to tell if an object is allowed to be placed based on the other generated tilemaps. I will handle this analogous to the place type. This means that you can define the rule either for the whole category or specifically for one building object. Go to your building creator and add a new variable. A list of building category. So for every category in this list, we don't want to place the current object if one of those maps already has a tile. So for example, we don't want to place an item if there's a wall. And the great news is, this also works for the own category. So I can't replace an item with another item. Now we can add the same field to the building object base. Additionally, above, I add a boolean to determine if I want to use the field below or the one from the category. This is needed because we can't just rely on an empty list, because an empty list might be what is wanted. In the getter, we check if the use placement restriction boolean is true. If yes, then we return the current list. Else, the one from the assigned category will be returned. Let's see how this looks in Unity. I can add multiple building categories as restrictions. So an item must not be placed where a wall is, but also not where another item is. A wall must not be placed on an item, and due to fictional resource management, a wall is not allowed to be placed on another wall. Now, remember the door is a wall, so let's override these settings here for the door. Activate the checkbox, and now we only add the item category as restriction, but not the wall anymore. Great, now we just need to expand our isForbidden method a little bit. So, we have the list of maps that will stay forbidden in our serialized variable. We now just need the tile maps connected to the restriction list and combine these two. In step 1, let's save the categories which are restricted in a separate variable. From this variable, we will now extract the tile maps for each one of the categories. By using the convertAll function, we can create a transform process which is applied to every item in a list and return it at the same position. So, for each category, convert it to the tilemap variable of this category. This is then saved in this list of tilemaps. Now, the final variable will be the combination of the two lists. Use one of the lists as first value and the second one as parameter inside the concat method. Then transform it back to a list. Just replace the variable here with the recently created one, and that's it. At first, let's validate if the previous functionality still works. Yep, I can't place something on the water. Now, let's test the rest. I can't place an item on a wall. I also can't place another wall on a wall. And a wall cannot be placed on the item. But the door has custom functionality. It still can't be placed on an item, but it is the only wall that can be placed on other walls. So everything works as expected. Of course, there are much more complex cases and ideas, but for the current use case it's completely fine and it integrates nicely with the existing functionality and code. If you have any questions or feedback, let me know in the comments or join my Discord server. Thank you for watching, and also thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Patrick and Naxwomo. Thank you all. And as usual, if you enjoy the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.